Well, buying a laptop is a heavy decision to make, and once you have made that decision, you cannot step back. It's a very big decision, big amount, and when we are investing in a good laptop, we need to make sure that it fulfills all our needs. Well, this year I bought the Lenovo LOQ 14th Gen with i7-14700HX. So let's see how this laptop is.
So we're gonna save that.
Lenovo's Legion series of gaming laptops are really good that can be used both for gaming and productivity, but it comes at a very hefty price. Not everyone is affordable for that price range. Here comes the Lenovo's LOQ series of laptop. Let's see if this year's Lenovo LOQ 14th Gen with Intel i7-14700HX is worth buying for the price at which it is available. Laptop. I've used this laptop for around 1 month and made a preview of this video. So stay till the end of this video to know if this laptop is worth buying. Specification: the model I have is Lenovo LOQ 2024 14th Gen with Intel Core i7-14700HX. It has a powerful graphics card of RTX 4060 with 8GB of VRAM. It comes with a 16GB DDR5-5600MHz RAM and 1TB of SSD. It has a IPS screen with 2560x1440 display. It has a 100% sRGB with 350 nits brightness and 165Hz of refresh rate. The design and build quality is decent. It has a plastic build quality, but the quality of the plastic is really good. There is a little bit of screen wobble noticeable, similar to the other gaming laptops in this price segment. There is a projection at the top of the screen which helps in opening the screen with one hand. The hinges of the laptop are sturdy. The laptop weighs approximately 3 kg with the adapter included. The weight might feel more when compared to the similarly priced MacBooks. Yes, as it is a gaming laptop, it definitely adds weight to your bag. When it comes to the keyboard, it's really good. It feels similar to the ThinkPad series of laptops. The spacious keyboard, the background is silver color with black color keys. There are three zones of lighting available in the keyboard, as you can see. There is little bit of flex to the keyboard, nothing that may draw your attention while typing. My typing experience was really good and the keyboard looks very professional. The touchpad is not that great. It is made up of plastic and has a gritty sensation when you are moving it, and the click is not that great. When it comes to the ports, the Lenovo has made a lot of changes. All the main ports are on the back of the laptop, and the sides of the laptop have only few ports. This year's LOQ laptop doesn't have any vents throwing out the air from the left and right sides of the laptop. All the vents go from the back of the laptop. The right side comes with a USB 3.2 Gen 2 Type-C port, a camera disconnect switch, a 3.5mm audio jack, and a Type-A port. The left side is completely empty, no ports, no vents, clean as a slate. The back has two Type-A port, one HDMI port, one Ethernet port, one power input port. I was really impressed by the quality and size of the screen. It is a 15.6-inch IPS screen with 2K display with 165Hz refresh rate. It comes with a black matte finish and it's really helpful to avoid glare on the screen, which is very common with the glassy screens.
Get your foot out of here! Twist your leg, you drunken bastard! Help! Help me, or we're both dead!
This laptop are not that great. You definitely need a headphones or external speakers to enjoy the music or to do productivity tasks. Battery life. As this is a gaming laptop, don't expect battery life from this laptop. When unplugged, it doesn't perform to its maximum power, and also it lasts maximum up to 3 hours. When you are plugged in, it draws the maximum energy and it gives the better performance. Lenovo has added 3 performance modes in the laptop which you can set. These performance modes adjust the span, speed and temperature management according to the type of performance we need. There are the 3 performance modes which are present in Lenovo LOQ series of laptop are the quiet, the performance, auto mode.
This is the fan noise when it is kept into the performance mode. This is the fan noise when it is kept in the quiet mode. This is the fan noise when it is kept in the auto mode.
The thermals are really good on this laptop. It doesn't allow the laptop to reach above 90 degrees Celsius. When it comes to the gaming performance, no matter what game I threw at it, it just handled everything buttery smooth. Considering the price at which it is available, I think it's the best performance you can get out of it. Even video editing is not a problem at all. It can manage all types of video editing footage very easily. So conclusion, I think this laptop is very good at the price range at which it is available. Even there are many student discounts available at the Lenovo's website. You can utilize it and reduce the price range to your budget.